Howdy, Sam from Maths, looking at algebraic formulae. So, what is a formula? So, one formula, you have multiple formulae, so formulae is plural. Formula is an equation with a variable on the left and an algebraic expression on the right. So I've got some examples here. So this one is universal gravitation. So the force experienced by an object due to gravity is equal to the gravitational constant, g, times the mass of the first object, times the mass of the second object, and we divide both of those by the radius, the distance between those objects, and we square the radius. This formula here tells us that every object, every piece of matter in the universe is attracting every other piece of matter in the universe. So it's a really important formula in physics. Here's one that you might have seen in maths, A equals half BH. This is how that we figure out the area of a triangle. So a triangle is half a rectangle, basically, and to figure out the area of a rectangle, you multiply your base by your height. So a triangle is half that. So here's another formula from physics, it's S equals UT plus half AT squared. Another formula is S equals UT plus half AT squared, and we use this in physics. We can use this formula to figure out the distance that an object travels in a gravitational field if we know its initial velocity. So it's a kind of very fun formula to use when we calculate how things falling, for example. So these are three formulae, and the reason why they're formulae, we have a variable on the left, and then we have an expression on the right. And we can substitute in values for what we know to figure out answers, answers to questions. Let's look at an example. So in our example, we're going to use this algebraic formula here. This is a formula used in physics to calculate kinetic energy. So kinetic energy, EK. Kinetic energy is the energy that anything has if it's moving. And our formula is, the kinetic energy is equal to half times the mass of the object you're moving, and you multiply that by the velocity squared. So we don't have any time symbols in here, but if there's no symbol connecting our bits, we just multiply. That's the assumption. So let's do a question. So we've got a 2 kilogram bag of flour, and it is going 8 meters per second. So ms minus 1, that's how we say meters per second. So every meter, every second, it travels 8 meters. So let's solve this equation. I'm going to go over here, so I'm going to use my information over here. So EK equals, all right, so I'll go to pink. Okay, so we've got half times by the mass. Now the mass was in green. So on my green, our mass is 2 kilograms. And we're going to multiply that by the velocity, which was 8 meters per second. So velocity is in orange. So 2 times 8, and we square that number. So what we did just there was substitution. We're substituting in numbers for our variables. Right, and from there we can start to solve, because we've just got numbers that we can work with. So each time we do an equals, we do just one step. So half times 2, that's 1. So half times 2, 2 halves make up 1. So that's the same as saying 1 times 8 squared. 8 squared is 64, so we have 64. Now, in physics, we have units when we're measuring things. So over here, we have kinetic energy, we've got mass, we've got velocity. Each of these has a unit. So our unit for energy is joules, velocity is meters per second, and mass is kilograms. So our answer there is 64 joules. So today on Flippin Maths, we looked at using algebraic formulae. That's it for Flippin Maths today. Bye.